What's up, traders? It's Chris here. So we got another top trade Forex review for you here. And so we're back on the normal schedule doing top Forex trade reviews on Tuesdays. And then on Friday, we'll be publishing a market commentary, a market analysis view, give you some trade ideas of what's going on. So this one is from Stefano. He's been with us for a few years. Great member, just a great member of the community. Super helpful to other members and just a fun guy to be around or just to have around here. So we're covering his trade on the EURCAD. These are the details from it. Entry 5219, stop loss 5113, take profit 5620, R2R plus 3.6, holding time 3 days. So if he had risked $100, he would have made $360 in profit on this one here. It's only 3 days work. And the thing never went into the negative. So this is the trade from his broker chart. This is CTrader. And here's his entry right here. And here's where he took profit. We are going to look at this on our chart here. So now you've seen the details. So let's go and look at this on the 1 hour chart here. All right. So I'm going to slide this over for a second. You can kind of see where he got in. He got in at 52.19, literally the bottom of this candle right here. And what he was thinking is that we have this kind of impulsive corrective move with a little bit of resistance here and a little bit of support here. And it just shoots higher. And this is a very short corrective structure. So 1 hour chart. So you're talking that it's only looking at maybe 6-8 hours and then it just shoots higher. Then it forms a large corrective structure and balancing zone here for a little bit. Kind of whipsaws a little bit, out, back in, out, finds a base, then shoots higher. A little wild price action, not respecting levels cleanly here. This was okay from here to here. But then it kind of overshoots and then slams back down, impulsive, corrective, impulsive. But then it just kind of stops and then looks for some liquidity and then launches higher. And that's where they got in. So you can see their entry location. You can see why this level makes sense. They're thinking, hey, this level is still going to be valid after holding here. And so that was their entry to get long. They put their stop loss below this here, and their take profit was 56.20. So if we slide this back, you can kind of see right about there is where it took profit. So now let's mark this horizontal line real quick. And we already have the entry and we already have the stop loss. So let's delete that for a second, kind of zoom in what's going on here. Let's zoom in 4 hour chart actually real quick. So we know the entry location, the stop loss is below this. Personally, I think it's a little too conservative because if you really think this is going to hold, then you can just have it a few pips, you know, below that. He had 51.13 and I think he could have shaved off a good 20, 30 points right there. And so on a target that was 400, roughly 400 points, you know, an extra 20 pips, 30 pips would have added a little bit to the bottom line. The other option that he could have done is if he really felt like this was going to hold, then he could have put it below this inside this kind of zone here. Anywhere in the middle of this would have been fine for that here. Would have given a little bit of playroom to, you know, kind of move around here and bounce around and then take off. So I think he could have gone for a little bit more aggressive stop loss either here or really tight below this level here. Would have saved us some upside. In terms of his target, I kind of see why he's doing it. He's playing it a little bit conservative. He's looking to target this stuff here. So I put a horizontal line here. You can kind of see it. This, 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 all these spikes here, this, this, this. He's trying to hit that. So he goes for a little bit before that. And personally, again, I think it was a little on the conservative side. I think you can go for a lot more meat on this enchilada here. And so I think that would have been kind of a little bit better target. Again, it would have added about another 40, 50 to the upside, plus another 20 on the stop loss, 60 pips extra on a 400 pip target. That would have added a lot more to his bottom line. But the entry is near perfect. I mean, literally, it did not go against him one pip, and it went straight into the positive. So I like that. He's trading basically a trend continuation play that after kind of bouncing around a bit that this market is going to continue to find support. And so overall, I give this, you know, A minus on this one here. The entry is near perfect. That is like A plus. Stop loss a little too conservative on that one there and target a little too conservative. But if he's playing set and forget, you know, I get it. You know, maybe he doesn't have time to manage it. So he can't watch all this here and he just sets the target a little bit conservative. Be done with it. If that's the case, then I understand this. If he's not, if he's watching in real time, then I would shoot for a little bit more on this one here, try and get closer to this resistance here. But other than that, I really like what he did on this one here. He stayed with trend. He found a good support level. He did not wait for confirmation or anything like that. Again, you wait for confirmation, you're going to miss a lot of setups. There was no pin bar here. You would have missed the setup completely. and you could have missed a perfectly profitable trade just because you're waiting for confirmation. We don't trade with confirmation. We trade using price action context and the order flow behind it. And when you build those skills really well, you don't need to wait for confirmation because confirmation is an illusion. There's only probabilities. That's all you're ever trading with. You stack the probabilities in your favor and you won't have to trade with confirmation. You'll get better entries and you'll get more profitability out of your trade. So congratulations to Stefano on this one here. We will be back on Friday. We will be talking about the stock market and various opportunities in that, and then what's going on in the markets as a whole, how we're trading it. And so I think there's gonna be a lot of interesting things you're gonna get out of this next video. So stay tuned for that, but make sure to smash the like button, join our channel, subscribe to our channel, and leave a comment below in this video on what you liked about it. We really appreciate it. It tells YouTube that people are engaging our videos, and then when people engage it, YouTube likes those our videos. They give us more bonus points in terms of our algorithm, and then they just gives us kind of this nice reciprocal cycle. You know, you comment, you subscribe, you like it. It helps us. We get to keep doing free videos for you guys and help teaching you for free. So I hope you enjoyed this video. I look forward to your comments and questions. Be safe out there with the coronavirus, of course, and be aggressive in the markets. There's a lot of great opportunities right now. And so good luck trading, and I'll see you in the next video.